Here we are at the orchard. Start of the tea trees. There we go. Feeling good. And it's 0.6. Almost exactly the same level as some of those training paddles. Mistakes. Looking good so far. Yeah. Bit of a pool to relax in now. You can get a bit of a lead on me again. Nice channel shoots off to the right there, I think, doesn't it? Yeah, I reckon so. There's another one coming up like that at the end of a pool. You're presented with almost the exact same options that we were just presented with there. And it's an even tighter right-hand channel, and you mustn't take that one. That one's the wrong one. But that one's obvious. You'll see straight ahead looks fine, and you'll think, oh, well, of course I'm not going right here, you know. So, The general rule though is, when in doubt, go take the right-hand channel. But only when you're in doubt. You know, only when they both look just as good as each other. Yeah, today's tea trees are all pretty straightforward though. You go where most of the water goes and you'll be okay. It's tomorrow that there's two decisions to make. Yep, straight through that gap. Couple of bit of side pressure, I guess. Yeah, okay. See, that V7's pretty maneuverable, eh? You're right side, yep. I tell people learning to paddle that the V7 is the perfect boat to start with. I think they'll probably stay with it for a long time. Don't need to upgrade. Yep. Stay on the right here, yeah. Cut that corner. All good. There's that graveyard on the left. I've been stuck in there before. Not fun. Not the way. I think that middle channel looks better. Plus, I think she might get a little bit stuck on that side one. Yeah, I'll follow you down middle. They both look just as good as each other, so no reason to go to the right. Straight ahead. Power. Gonna push you left. Yep. Goodo. Yeah, that's just an S bend on the side there. Yep, perfect. Right side. Yep. Yeah, done. Follow the water to the left, yeah. Yep. As soon as you can, get into her channel on the right there. Yep. All right. Well done, you got through that gap all right. Yeah. We took the alternative route thinking that if you were stuck there, then we might be stuck behind you, but you got through, no worries. Oh, well, all about the same pace, I think, you know. But I'll go in front so that I can take a video if you guys stuff up. See, that's how it works. Because then get the added bonus of more people watching my videos. Jeez, I didn't recognize a bit of that up there. I've done this thing 5 times this year and it didn't look familiar. But so much water everywhere. You know, all these channels are open. Ducking under logs is going to be the hardest part of the day, I think. Yeah. Well, It's a 10 centimeter increase in height and water level, but we came down when it was 0.65 and I got under the logs. Just, but got under, so that's right. So we're hoping that no matter what, those logs on day two will be under, or be able to go under, yeah. Because wow, the central channel on the other side of the island there, that's not passable. I've got a great video from I think about 5 years ago. Everyone was going down the right and it was dry. So they then jumped out of the river and pulled their boat over that island. And I thought I was being smart by going to the other side of the island. And it was just as dry as the other side. So we both ended up having to carry our boats onto opposite sides of the same island. We like crossed each other because we both picked the wrong way. And I think that was 2010 in fact. That was the lowest. Wasn't that long ago. But it was to the point where everybody was helping each other portage 2 minutes after the start of the day. Might have been 14, yeah. But geez, we're so lucky that now even at 0.4 you can get through those channels because they've been scoured out. So it's just I wonder where has all that sand been deposited though. A few years ago after the floods, there were enormous sandbanks halfway down the valley. Yeah. And luckily they didn't sort of change anything major, but you can imagine they could have blocked the whole river and, you know, made another set of rapids somewhere. Okay, so I think I was just telling other bloke there that there's a decision to make at the end of a pool coming up where there's a nice channel on the perpendicular to the right, and I've always thought, oh, that's a good way, let's go there, and it's not the way. But the one up there was very similar, but it wasn't, that was definitely right side correct. But now it's it could be here. I don't think it's here though. It's got a gravel, the right side has a big gravel chute in it, and there's a log coming out across the gravel chute, and my god, it's difficult, but you don't need to go there. So I went there 3 times in a row thinking it was the way. And then Dave Tupling and Pat went the other way and said, why wouldn't you come here? So I learnt the lesson. This is not that one. Yeah. I've messed this one up a few times as well. I'm gonna cut this corner here and go here. I think this is the safest way through. False timbering. V. Unlucky, mate. That's a tough bit there. Yeah, yeah. Bank over there. Bank over there looks better than the other. Oh, good luck. You got your paddle? You got everything? Yep. Good-o. Good luck, mate. I think our boat is leaking. Only a little bit though. Very manageable. There's the tunnel tree. Could have gone left or right there, no worries. Another fake jimpity. Thank you. looks like jimpeting. Is it? Nope. Nope, fake jimpeting again. Another pool. I know this one. All right, we're going to go this way today. There's enough water. That way it looks a bit bony. Derp. Here's our channel from past paddles. Pretty much the same way, isn't it? The nose. pleasure. It is indeed. Thanks, guys. Not far now. Oh, yeah. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
That's right.
Easier than the alternative, which is up there. There's a gravel bank in front of us. That'll get some people. And Dave reckons that way is good. I reckon this way is also fine. Okay. I think that was jimpening, wasn't it? Willie hears ya. Willie don't care. Oh no, he's turned over. Oh no! Unlucky, mate. The worst part is you were too far away and I didn't get it on video. There's always next time. You right? No worries. I'll see you at the finish. That's about 2Ks. About 2Ks to the finish. Maybe 2.5. Pretty close. Can't be more than 3. He's just annoyed. Pretty soon. 3Ks from there. Grand Earth House. Oh, sorry. Right hand channel. Alrighty, Rammed Earth House, supposed to be 3Ks to the finish. I don't know. Hoping it's more like 2. Yeah. and muddy. Wow. Take your time, all the time you got, you're all right. Oh, yep. Grab onto the main branch, grab onto the main log. Yep, pull yourself. Yep. Yeah. Well done, you. You right there?
Yeah.
I mean, you can shoot if you want.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Wow. Thanks, man. Oh. See, not long to go now, eh? Yeah. The the ducking is the easy part. It's these three things after it that are the ones. All right. I think that's it, isn't it? Isn't it the pool above Leatherheads now? That's where the old Dage used to be in the TiTrees on our left. Whoop, you're right, yep. All good. Go. All good. It's hilarious, mate. That's the tree that we always used to come out of the TiTrees, check the gauge, and then hit that tree and turn over. It was a classic thing that we say, all right, guys, now we're at the end of the TiTrees. There's the gauge. Don't look at it. Keep paddling. Look in front of you. Ah! I think this is the pool above Leatherheads, so no more tea trees now, just two pools and then Leatherheads. Love it. I won't catch you. I'll see you. Oh, yeah. He's coming. Glad it wasn't out all day because the sunnies would be needed. eye is so bad if it's out all day. The reflection. Is that Leatherheads right in front of us there? It's another pool, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. We're in an eddy over this side now, I think. Across. I don't know. Much of a muchness. Trying to get that extra little kilometer an hour. At least there's no giant sandbar in the middle of this pool.
We've got about a K to go, I think.
That's right, yep. Just the pool around the corner, and then around the next corner is Leatherheads. Funny, the estimates of distance are pretty wrong, but we've been about 3 km in front of the estimates up until now, and this last one is 3 km longer than the estimate, and it gets you back on par.
Yeah.
So it's like, if you go on the how many k's between things, we should have been finished a k and a half ago.
Yeah.
49 k's, but I mean, you know, yeah, it's supposed to add up to 52, so. TiTrees are actually 3 km longer than I think they've told people. Yeah. Yeah, this is the last pool, I think. Yeah. I'll see you the finish, man. Good luck. Good luck. I'll see you finish. Cheers. Like Leatherheads. So usually there'd be people at Leatherheads. Another pool. This is the pool that never ends. Right channel, right channel, right, right, right. Right side, if you can. It's easier. No worries. Yeah, you miss out all the rocks. Forget about this little bit. Feels like we should be there by now. Yeah. You want to cut right somewhere? Yeah, yeah. Leatherheads is just around the corner here. Because I had all the estimates wrong, where we get to 2J and it says on my watch, it told me 29 kilometers, whereas it should be 32. So we were 3 kilometers shorter to 2J, but to get back on par, it's 3 kilometers longer in the TiTrees. So the TiTrees become 16 Ks from Wetherill instead of 11, like it's supposed to be. You're thinking, oh god. So that's why I thought. Yeah. Oh, okay. I was wondering how long have you had that boat? How long have you been making friends with the Waypopper for?
2 years, probably, since the second
year. Yep. Okay.
Last year I had a
rudder. Oh, that's right. That's right. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
There's that other lady who was also paddling without a rudder. Yeah. 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 She's behind us, isn't she? Yeah, she came, I passed her at extracts. Okay. Oh, your first solo, hey? Well done. Yeah. Sorry? This is number 20. I gotta include the unofficial one though. Yeah, it looks cool, eh? It's the only medal we're gonna get this year because it looks like the normal medals haven't arrived yet. Yeah. If only we could get those every year. I'll see you at the finish, eh? Okay, now we gotta be at Leatherheads. Hooray! Here we are, Leatherheads! In the gap. Yeah, boy. Big old flat rock here. Thanks.
You.
Man. Your hands must be sore by clapping all day by now. Oh, God. We gotta finish this one in reverse, right? How could I spiff up the day? Cheers, guys.
Yee-hoo.
Both ways.
Yee-hoo.
She beat me. You're on YouTube now. Woo. Long day. 6 hours and 1 minute. If I hadn't have done that silly backwards maneuver, I would have been under 6 hours. But... I'm perfectly happy with whatever time they give me, I'm perfectly happy with, hey. Oh, mate. Couldn't be better level. Wow, everything's open and fun and...
Yeah, that's great.
zero support crew here, so they had to go to the footy.
So,
yeah, the derby. Had to go early. Yeah, yeah. Do you want to empty it? I can empty it here if you like. That don't like to grab onto things after the race. Oh, thanks. I'm a dragger nowadays. I just put it on the ground and drag it. Anyway, that's good. Cheers. I'll just put the bung back in because it has a tendency to break off when you leave it out like that. And then it's left in the grass somewhere. Hey! Excellent, excellent. And it's on video. I like it. You meant to do that. Awesome. Thanks, guys.